Okay, so we've all seen the generative fill feature in Photoshop being used to extend a scene or to replace objects. Now let me show you a way I use them to create these animated paintings. For today's tutorial, I'll be using videos that I took on my iPhone, and I've already graded them on DaVinci, and I've converted into a JPEG sequence with a frame rate of usually around 8 FPS. And I'm assuming you already know how to create the paint look with the generative fill feature. If you don't, this tutorial here might help you out. This tutorial might help you out. This one over here. Okay. Otherwise, I'll quickly brush through the process actually. Okay, so this first clip, we're going to create that paint look. So press Q and then change the brightness of this black into something around like 10. And then select the whole image with the rectangle shape tool, press Q again, and then enter the prompt, oil painting. Now, once I get my result, I select the layer mask and I mask out the areas where I want to show movement. In this case, the street area, so I can show the car pass by. Now, once you have this painting layer masked out, you can actually export this and just overlay over your footage. But what I ended up doing is just doing the whole thing on Photoshop and exporting individual frames by turning on and off one frame after the other. And I did this so I can get the stop motion look on each clip. But you can probably do the same thing on your editing program. This is just the way I did it because I was kind of doing it on the fly. Anyway, the second clip, I used a slightly different technique. So for this clip, I actually only used one frame from the video. So you can actually do this technique on a photo. But first, we'll generate the paint look again with the same process. Now, analyze where you want to show movement. In this case, I wanted to show the wind blowing on these lanterns. I also wanted to show a shimmer on the reflections on the windows. And this is how I did it. You just duplicate the generated layer, or you can regenerate a whole new layer with a lower percentage, which I would actually recommend. So we've been generating these paint looks with like around 10%, but I would recommend to go around 3%, just so the changes to the image are more subtle. Now turn off all the layers underneath, then go to the layer mask and erase the whole layer with black. Once it's all masked out, I'm going to turn on the layer underneath so I can see where I'm masking, and then paint white over the areas where I want the movement. So I'm going to paint over these lanterns and the highlights on the windows. Once you've done that, if you turn off the layer underneath, you can see where you've painted. Now I just need to generate as many variations I need and export each variation individually. This third clip is very similar to how I did the first technique. So I just mask out the areas of movement, which is over at the back over here. It's important to do this on areas that are small so it looks more convincing. Earlier in this clip, a kid zooms with the scooter as well. So I kind of struggled to find a way to do this, but the way I ended up doing this, I just used a cutout of this kid, exported it separately, and then animated him moving from one end to the other in DaVinci. Okay, moving on to these four clips. I'm just gonna do them all together since I did the same technique. So for this clip, I masked out the areas where these guys are walking. This clip, I masked out the man and the lady and also the escalator. And this clip, I masked out the group of people taking selfies and also this couple walking out. And it's important to also just mask where they are in the first frame and also looking at where they end up on the last frame and masking in between that, if you know what I mean. Over to this next clip of this building, I just generated another layer of painting masked out, so it's only showing the reflections on the windows and the highlights, pretty much the bright parts of the windows, and then just generated X amount of variations and exported them individually. Now these last two clips are a little different. I generated another layer another painted layer with a low percentage as well. But this time I move this new layer below this first one. And then I mask the first layer on top with a low opacity. So I'm slightly revealing the bottom layer. You can see in the original clip, there's a lot of movement on the ground because of the shadows. So I pretty much masked the areas, like the shadow areas, to show that the shadows of the trees change. And for this clip, I masked out the trees, the oceans, and the clouds. And the mask is going to be hard to see, but once you generate new variations and flick through the variations, you will notice the subtle animations of the shadows, trees, and the water and the clouds. Once you've exported all the layers, I usually put it together in my editing program. In my case, I actually already edited the whole video on DaVinci, so I'm pretty much just putting the images on top of my original edit, and you should be done after that. There's actually so many possibilities you can use with this technique, so make sure to just experiment, and I'd love to see what you guys create. So if you want, you can tag me on Instagram or TikTok. Now, if you found this video helpful, I'd love it if you can subscribe or just leave a comment. And I also do have other tutorials on Photoshop Beta, so make sure to check those out as well. I'll see you guys in the next video.